तिच्या राहण्यासाठीची पर्यायी व्यवस्था करून देऊ शकत असाल, जसं की एक भाड्याचं घर एका एक्स रकमेला मिळत असेल तर ती जी रक्कम आहे ती देण्यासाठी तुम्ही तयार असाल, तर मात्र कोर्ट तिला असं म्हणू शकतं की तुम्ही ती रक्कम घ्या आणि एक भाड्याचं घर घेऊन त्याच्यामध्ये राहा. अशा केसमध्ये कोर्ट असं म्हणू शकत नाही की तुम्ही आत्ता राहत आहात तिथेच राहा, तर कोर्ट असं म्हणतं की ती भाड्याची रक्कम घ्या आणि जे भाड्याचं घर आहे त्या घरात राहा. पण हे अवलंबून आहे जर तुम्ही पर्यायी व्यवस्था करून देऊ शकत असाल तरच. जर तुम्ही पर्यायी व्यवस्था करून देऊ शकत नसाल तर मात्र तिला त्या घरातून कोणीही बाहेर काढू शकत नाही. हाच व्हिडिओ इंग्लिश लँग्वेजमध्ये सुद्धा अपलोड केलेला आहे, त्याची लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्समध्ये दिलेली आहे. जर आपल्याला हा विषय इंग्लिशमध्ये समजून घेण्याचा असेल तर त्या लिंकवर आपण क्लिक करा, आपण तोच व्हिडिओ इंग्लिशमध्ये सुद्धा बघू शकता.
जर आपल्याला हा व्हिडिओ आवडला असेल तर कृपया व्हिडिओ लाईक करा, कृपया चॅनल सबस्क्राईब करा आणि बेल आयकन क्लिक करा. धन्यवाद. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for the future uploads.
Hello everyone. Common man does not know legalities, and therefore when the time comes that he wants some legal answers, he depends upon either internet, books or legal advice by a lawyer. In this clip, it is an effort to answer many of such frequently asked questions by a client. It will clarify most of your doubts, queries and questions. In this session, we are going to discuss the questions related to divorce case. Now, a lady client who is seeking divorce from her husband has come to me and she has a few questions in her mind. Let's see what the questions are and what the answers to those questions are.
I want to file a case of divorce against my husband. What information will you require from me?
As far as the divorce is concerned, it is a very wide concept, and there are various grounds available for a woman to file a case against the husband. Few of the grounds are cruelty, adultery, desertion, or if he is guilty of rape, sodomy or bestiality or something like that. In this scenario, usually what we use in the court is either cruelty or desertion or adultery. These are the three most commonly used grounds. As far as cruelty is concerned, it can be mental, it can be physical it can be financial. As far as desertion is concerned, if your husband has left you and is living separately for more than 2 years, you can file the case of desertion. And as far as adultery is concerned, if your husband is living an adulterous life, then we can use this ground also. But as far as adultery is concerned, we refrain ourselves from filing a case of adultery unless there is a video recording or video proof available of such adultery, or there is a child born from such adulterous relationship which we can establish in the court. Otherwise, we don't take the ground of adultery. The most common grounds which are used are cruelty and desertion. So as far as information required from your side is concerned, I want the details as to when the cruelty has been inflicted by your husband, that is the date, the time and the place of the alleged cruelty. So whatever cruelty that has been inflicted by your husband, we have to mention each and every instance separately. So as far as information is concerned, I want all the instances that has taken place in your matrimonial life, date wise, time wise and month wise. So you have to write down everything. As far as desertion ground is concerned, I want the details as to when your husband has left the matrimonial home, and after he has left for 2 years or more, what efforts you have made. So on this day, I sent an SMS to my husband to come back, or on this day, I had sent him a notice, or on this day, I sent my friend or relative to him to convince him to please come back. So likewise, we have to mention all the instances, and that is the information which is required from your side to me.
Which documents are essential to file a case?
Basically, to file a case of divorce, we have to establish the marriage first. To establish the marriage, we require marriage proofs. And the marriage proofs can be marriage invitation card, marriage photographs, and if that marriage is registered, then marriage registration certificate. So these three constitute the marriage proofs. Also, if there is a child born from the marriage, we have to submit the birth certificate of the child, wherein the name of the parents is mentioned in it. Also, ID and address proof of the person filing the case is also required at the time of filing the case. If you had sent any notice to your husband, or if there is any other relevant document which can establish your case in the court, we can file that document also, like audio or video recording document, or any medical report, or any other document for that matter, we can file in the court.
Is it necessary to send a private notice?
Legally speaking, sending a private notice is not incumbent on the parties, meaning it is not an essential aspect to file a case of divorce that you have to send a legal notice through an advocate to your husband. But many a times advocate try to send a notice of divorce to see whether there is a chance of mutual consent divorce or not. I will say that even if you file a case of divorce against your husband, there can be very well a counseling session being conducted in the court, or a mediation process wherein we can try for mutual consent divorce if possible or not. But as far as notice is concerned, it is like making the opposite party aware about your intentions, and then the opposite party can take the precautionary measures. Also, I don't like to send a notice because in the notice, we have to mention the entire contents of the petition. So, the husband will be aware that what you are going to file against him, and he can definitely create evidence to counter such allegations beforehand. And that's why I am very much reluctant to send a notice. But still, many people try to convince the client to send a notice. There is no bar to send a notice. Also, there is no hindrance if the notice is sent.
If my husband is not ready to give me divorce, can I get it?
Since your husband is not ready to give divorce, that's why we are going to file a one-sided case. If your husband was very much willing to give you divorce, we could have filed a mutual consent divorce petition. If he is not ready, therefore, we are taking the recourse of either cruelty or desertion or any other ground for that matter. And if you prove it, definitely the court is going to grant you divorce on that ground.
Even if I want divorce, Can I claim maintenance?
Maintenance and divorce are two separate issues. As far as maintenance is concerned, the court sees the financial capacity of the parties. So if you have amount which is sufficient for you, or if you are getting an amount which is sufficient for yourself, definitely the court is not going to grant you maintenance even if you want divorce or you don't want divorce. But in a scenario